Today, I want to introduce you to the new AI we've implemented in Substance 3D Sampler. This artificial intelligence allows you to generate a PBR material from a single image. This new AI uses different algorithms based on material categories, like plastic, ground, fabric, wood, etc. Here we can see ceramic tiles generated from the ceramic algorithm. The concrete and asphalt category can be used to generate concrete walls. Here's some knitted fabrics generated using the fabric algorithm. The leather algorithm can generate different types of leathers. Of course, the ground category that is the default category in the image-to-material AI powered. The AI now works also with metallic materials. The organic category works fine with food and skin materials. The paper category can generate paper grains, cardboard, and torn paper. Here are some plastic materials generated by using the plastic category. Two different types of bricks generated by using the terracotta category. The wood category will work fine to generate wood patterns, parquet, and wood planks. Finally, the wood outdoor is more specialized in tree bark materials. Now that we've seen what is possible to generate with this new AI, let's have a look at the image-to-material workflow. I will use this subway floor to generate my material. Let's drag and drop it in Sampler. In the pop-up window, we select the image-to-material AI powered. My image has a resolution of 2048 pixels. Sampler will round off the document size to the nearest highest power of 2 resolution, in this case 2K. Let's click on Import. If we look at the layer stack, we see now resolution by layer. If you want to know more about layer resolution, there is an official tutorial about the texture upscaling workflow using layer resolution mods. Here, with the ground category, we already have a good result. The delighting of the base color works well, and the normal and the height lets appear big bumps and small bumps on the surface. Let's try another algorithm by selecting the plastic rubber category. The result works well too. The overall material is sharper and flatter. The bumps are more defined. Don't hesitate to try several categories on the same image input and keep the best result. In my case, I like the output of the ground algorithm, so I will select it. Before tweaking the parameter of the image to material filter, I like to drop a height to normal layer. It allows me to set correctly my normals. The intensity parameter sets the normal intensity baked from the height of the image to material. And the bottom normal intensity parameter allows us to add to the mix the normal from the layer below. In our case, the normal generated by the AI. Now we can come back into the image to material to fine-tune the surface detail of the normal and the height with the micro details, the medium details, and the large details parameters. Finding a good balance will add photorealism to your materials. We can also adjust the ambient occlusion intensity. Finally, we can select if our material is matte or shiny, and fine-tune the base value for more glossy or rough materials. The variations parameter will introduce some big roughness variation, and the albedo importance will add fine details in our roughness maps. Now I want to show you a trick to restore some details in your base color, height, roughness, or any other map. To do so, we can use the channel switch filter to input details from your original image inside any channel we'd like. If the delighting is too high, for example, we can add our original image to the mix by selecting Scan 1 and selecting Base Color as the output channel. Now we can play with the opacity and blending modes or change the output channel to roughness or any other maps to add details to these maps. To better repeat the material, we want to even out the channel with an equalize. We can set the common radius lower to equalize more the maps. If some channels need to have another radius, we can override it with this parameter. We can see that some local areas are too uniform now in the base color. We can use the mask option to deactivate the equalizing locally. Now our material is uniformed, so let's style it. First, we want to realign the bump pattern so the surface can repeat uniformly. To do so, we can use a paint warp. We can set it to straighten mode and paint some vertical stroke that follows the pattern flow to realign it. Let's switch to the 2D viewport and paint some lines with the help of the Shift key to draw the lines. The pattern is realigned vertically. Let's do the same for the horizontal axis. We drop another paint warp and set it to horizontal and straighten mode. We can paint horizontal lines following the pattern flow with the Shift key. Now our material is straightened and can be tiled. Let's add a tiling filter and crop the material until the opposite side aligned together. The vertical and the horizontal sides are matching now. Let's add a bit of blur to fade a bit the seams. Now our material is seamless and can be repeated on large surfaces. For better repetitions, we could erase locally some visible imperfection with the clone stamp. We can move the source area with the pointer in the 2D view. Then paint on the imperfection to erase it. Again, like the tiling filter, we can fade the seams with the blur parameter. Let's redo the same process for this imperfection. We can click with the Ctrl key to set our source and then paint on the imperfection to erase it. Also, we will use the blur parameter to fade a bit the seams. Perfect, I think we are done with the post-processing of our material. Now we are ready to export. We can click on the share icon, rename the material, and in the material settings, we can select the export format and the size. We can also check the map that we want to keep in the SBSAR. Finally, we can export. During this tutorial, we had an overview of the capacity of this new AI available in Substance 3D Sampler. You will be able to convert images to high-quality PBR materials. Also, we've learned some tips and tricks to post-process the maps. This update brings the material creation from images to the next level. I'm looking forward to see your outputs. Thanks for watching.